This is Arthur Robinson Jr., and I'm back. And I'm back because I wanted to elaborate on the topic I was just discussing about, which is true friendship. There it is right here. I'm still on that same topic, friendship. Now, I wanted to elaborate about who is willing to stick with you through the rain? Who is willing to stick with you when your skies is gray? Who is willing to stick with you when your chips is down? Because remember, ups and downs will always be around. And when your skies is gray and when you feel as though there's no hope, let's just say that you got laid off from your job. And that is a difficult time, especially if you're depending on your job for income. But let's just say that you have a family member. It could be your mother, it could be your father, it could be your son or daughter that passed away. Well, that's an unfortunate incident. But let's just say, can you go to your friends and they willing to uplift you, they willing to encourage you, they willing to inspire you that it's going to be okay. That just leave that difficult situation in God's hands, and God is going to work. He's going to make sure that he works the situation out. So ask yourself, when you're in the rain, are your friends willing to empower you and inspire you, and they're willing to say it's going to be okay? Or, you know, you get into a difficult situation, are they willing to say, you know what, I can't help you, I don't have time to hear about your pain, I'm dealing with my own problems on my own. Now, you have to reevaluate your friendship. If you have a man or a woman that's saying that to you, then they're not your friends. If you're going through difficult times and you are revealing to your friends your pain, because remember, when you are feeling down, you want somebody to talk to, somebody that you can count on, somebody you can say, that's my friend. Man or woman, I can talk to this person about any situation that's transpired into a bad situation. And I know I can count on my friends to make me feel good, where they're going to turn that negative situation to a positive situation. Do your friends always want to take money from you? But then when you go and ask, you know, can I borrow some money? And when you go and ask, can I, you know, have some money because I want to take a vacation, or I want to, you know, to go to the mall and purchase, you know, some beautiful clothes. To all the women out there, I want to go to the mall, and that's how I want to go to Victoria's Secret to purchase me a lovely lingerie. You might want to purchase a lovely lingerie for your man or your husband. To all the women out there, to the fellas out there, you might say, you know, can I borrow, you know, $50, $100? I want to, you know, get my woman some beautiful roses or some beautiful carnations. And trust me, my woman loves flowers. And I know to each and every one of you out there, I know your woman and your wife, they love flowers as well. But anyway, that's what I wanted to talk about, is friendship. Who is willing to stand with you in the rain? See, when you have money, all your friends want to be your buddy and honey. But when you're broke, or you lose your job, or let's say your job start downsizing and they sell your job to an overseas market in China and India, you have to ask yourself, when the skies is gray, can I count on my friends, or are they just there because I have money? They're always around when good times is around. But when the bad times come around, they're not around at all. When I call them, I can't get in contact with them. When I call and leave a message on their cell phone, I can't get in contact with them. And they don't want to even hear from me. So you have to reevaluate your friendship. Don't hang around people that's not going to encourage you. Don't hang around people that's not going to uplift you. Don't hang around people that's not going to inspire you. Because remember, in order to inspire others, you have to be inspired yourself. And God put you on this planet to be giving, to be kind-hearted, to be understanding, and to be compassionate. And I'm a compassionate man. I'm compassionate for my family. So you have to ask yourself, are you compassionate towards your family? Are you compassionate towards your children? Are you compassionate towards your coworkers? Because The only thing that we have 100% of control over is our attitude. And when you have a positive attitude, you are always going to express gratitude. So be grateful for what you do have. So this is Arthur Robinson Jr. signing off, and I just want to touch bases once again about true friendship. Do not hang around people that don't believe in you. Cut them off. Don't hang around losers. So this is Arthur Robinson Jr. once again. I just want to touch base with you about friendship. And remember, the strongest muscle in your body is your brain. What you ultimately think about will become your reality. This is Arthur Robinson Jr. signing off. And always remember, always love yourself. Bye for now.